Hello friends, how are you? In today's this clinic, I will show you the method of examining the nose. So mainly some instruments they are required when we are examining the nose. This is the nasal speculum, pudicum nasal speculum, and it should be held in the left hand. Or you should have rather practice of attending the both in the left hand, and then we can, and you can see it, that it has got a spring-like action. So when you are releasing, it should be released very slowly. Suddenly if you release, then they will occur, it can damage the nasal cavity, mucosa. And when we are passing this instrument into the nasal cavity, it should remain only in the vestibule of the nose, because the vestibule of the nose is covered by skin, and its tip should not go beyond that. Because if the tip will touch the nasal mucosa, then it will be painful, patient will not allow you. So and when you are releasing, release it slowly. So this was the nasal, this thoracic nasal speculum, and then for the posterior rhinoscopy examination, so this anterior rhinoscopy examination will be performing with the help of thoracic nasal speculum, and posterior rhinoscopy examination will be performed with the help of this posterior rhinoscopy mirror. So you can see this cow, that is the characteristic feature of this rhinoscopic mirror. There is a laryngeal mirror, there will not be any curve, it will state mirror only. In this car, you can see in this shaft there is no curve. So this bayonet shaped, that is the characteristic feature of posterior rhinoscopic mirror, where the laryngeal mirror is straight, the shaft is straight. And then in children, we can take even the help of otoscope. So that otoscope should have quite wide nasal speculum, and with the help of this otoscope, we can examine the nasal cavity in children, particularly in infants, small children. So, like otoscope only, we'll have to hold it, and we can see the inside structure of the nasal cavity. But this is only again for small young small children, infants. Now we'll begin the examination proper. So during the examination, first we will examine the external nose. So we should see the shape of the nose. We can see for any crookedness, any deviation, or any sort of hump in the on the dorsum of the nose, that we should note, and any scar, if there is any, that we can see. If any swelling is there in the midline or in the lateral part, that we can see. Or in the surrounding area also, sometimes smooth swelling occurs here in this region, and that is due to the nasolabial cyst. So smooth swelling in the vestibule, we can see the swelling over the tip of the nose or even the skin of the vestibule of the nose. So that occurs in the fruncal. And when we are passing, holding this nasal speculum in the left hand, and then we should hold the patient's head. Show. So that will stabilize the patient's head, and then we should pass the nasal speculum. And you can see again, when we are examining the nasal cavity, we'll have to rotate the head up. And laterally and medially, so that if we are examining the septum of the nose, we'll have to hold and rotate it like medially, and if we are examining the lateral wall, then we should rotate it on the lateral wall of the nose. So in this, you can see the anterior end of the inferior turbinate, and then in some of the patients, we can see, even in this patient, we are not able to see anything beyond inferior turbinate, so we could see only the. And there are two methods of widening this nasal vestibule. This first method I showed you. Another method is this one. In both the way, we can dilate the nasal vestibule. So this is the floor of the nose, septum of the nose, inferior turbinate, and end, you can see, and superiorly, no more structure is visible. But in some of the nasal cavities, we can see. So ideally, in this patient, we could see only the anterior end of the inferior turbinate. We can see some anterior part of the nasal septum, floor of the nasal cavity, but we were not able to see the middle turbinate, middle meatus, and inferior meatus. But in some of the patients, very nicely, we can see all these structures that I mentioned. Again, I will repeat. The middle turbinate, inferior turbinate, middle meatus, and inferior meatus, these structures we can see. But in this particular patient, there is little hypertrophy of the inferior turbinate, and that is not allowing us to see beyond the inferior turbinate. Similarly, when we are examining the septum, we should see the lateral area, that is the anterior inferior part of the nasal septum, and that is the commonest site for this epistaxis nasal bleeding. So that area we should check, and whether there is any deviation of the nasal septum. Again, it's a very common condition. So if there is deviation, that also we should note. Any hypertrophy of the inferior turbinate, that also we should note. And in the middle meatus, we should see for any purulent discharge. Because if the patient is suffering from sinusitis, we can see the purulent secretions in the middle meatus. As you know, in the middle meatus, anterior sinuses, they open there. Anterior sinuses, they include the frontal sinus, maxillary sinus, and anterior ethmoidal sinuses. So these sinuses, they open into the middle meatus, whereas the posterior ethmoidal sinus, that opens into the superior meatus. And the sphenoidal sinus will open into the sphenoethmoidal recess. So we won't be able to see the sphenoethmoidal recess in an anterior rhinoscope examination, but even superior turbinate and superior meatus also, they are not visible in the anterior rhinoscope examination. And to examine this structure, we'll have to go for nasal endoscopy. So in this session, I will not be showing the nasal endoscopy procedure, but we are talking about just the clinical examination. So we can divide the clinical examination into two parts. The first is the physical examination and then the functional examination. Right now we have talked about the physical examination. The physical examination will include the external examination, then the external examination of anterior rhinoscopy, and then even the posterior rhinoscopy, that is the part of this physical examination. And in functional examination, we should try to ascertain the patency of the nasal cavity, whether the patient knows his patent, means can breathe or not, or whether there is any obstruction. And then we should test the olfaction. So that will complete the diagnosis. And after performing this physical examination, we should not forget to palpate the draining lymph nodes. So most of these lymph nodes, they drain into the upper deep cervical group of lymph nodes. So that also we should palpate. Thank you. So after performing this physical examination, we should palpate the lymph nodes which drain this area. So the posterior part of the nasal cavity and nasal pharynx, that will drain into the retropharyngeal lymph nodes. And from there, they will be draining into the deep cervical group of lymph nodes. So retropharyngeal, we will not be able to palpate, but the deep cervical lymph nodes we should, and submandibular lymph nodes, that we should try to palpate. Because this vestibular area, that will drain into the submandibular region. And then the upper deep cervical group, that we should palpate, and the posterior group. And then we should perform the palpation also. So palpation will tell us where the swelling is, whether it is in the cartilage part. As you know, this part is formed by the nasal bone, and the inferior part, this will be formed by the upper lateral nasal cartilage. So these also we should palpate. And this is the junction of the nasal and cartilage part. You can see this is the junction, and that is the common site of this opening of this dermoid, congenital dermoid cyst. Then we should palpate even the orbital margins also. And then we should perform the see whether there is tenderness or not. So this will help in eliciting the tenderness of the maxillary sinus. And for the frontal sinus, we should hold it like this and press it. So this will elicit the any tenderness in the frontal sinus. The method of performing posterior rhinoscopy examination. So in the performing posterior rhinoscopy examination, we will need the tongue depressor that we should hold in the left hand, and then we will need the posterior rhinoscopy mirror. These two instruments, they are required. Now I will show the proper method. In the left hand, we should hold the tongue depressor and should press the tongue. Mouth pura kholo apna, mouth pura kholo, pura mouth kholo. And then we will introduce the posterior rhinoscopy mirror. The posterior rhinoscopy mirror, you should not touch the posterior pharyngeal wall. Pura mukh kholo, naak se saans lo, lambe lambe. And then we should try to see the structure of the nasal pharynx, the lateral wall of the nasal pharynx. That in that lateral wall, we can see the opening of the eustachian tube towards the tube areas, fossa prosimula, posterior pharyngeal wall. And anteriorly, we can see the posterior ends of the nasal cavity. In the posterior corona, we can see. And in that, we can see the posterior end of the turbinates, middle turbinate, inferior turbinate, superior turbinate, and the posterior end of the meatuses, superior meatus, middle meatus, and the inferior meatus. Now I will show you the functional examination of the nasal cavity, how it is, that is performed. So first we'll perform the spatula test. In spatula test, first we'll perform the spatula test. In the spatula test, we put the speculum and tongue depressor just below the nose and ask the patient exhale out. You can see this fogging. And we should compare this fogging from the left and right side. In this particular case, you can see equal fogging on both the sides. There is another method of eliciting the patency. We can take a wisp of cotton and that we can put just below the nose and ask the patient to exhale. Saans bahar kado. Exhale kar jooste. Yes. So these are the two methods of jamming. Then there is Kotal test that we perform for the nasal valve. So for that we'll have to retract the L of the nose superiorly and laterally like this. And ask the patient whether she has some improvement in the nasal breathing or not. हम करवा दी सब लागे से श्वास लेवाई से सारो सो दिस वाज द पार्ट ऑफ दिस फंक्शनल एग्जामिनेशन एंड वी आर चेकिंग द मेनली द नेजल पेटेंसी एंड देन वी कैन परफॉर्म इन ऑल्फैक्टरी ऑल्फैक्शन आल्सो सो फॉर दैट 4-5 कॉमन स्मेल्स पेशेंट दे आर एक्सपोज टू दैट एंड देन पेशेंट शुड बी एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई द डिफरेंट स्मेल्स एंड थैंक यू